Make a shooter movie, come bang like mango. Boom, 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 how this thing so bingo. Wondering if he got understand my lingo. Is it now, he got life at home, but I need just a night alone. If I keep playing, you know I'm gone. I'm gonna run away, I'm gonna run away.
I couldn't get you off my mind.
I can tell you can
Testing, testing, testing. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. Testing, testing. Testing. Woo! Roxanne, Roxanne. Testing, testing, testing. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. Testing, testing. What? Yeah. Whee! I don't know if this is actually called Lady Jack Park, but I call it Lady Jack Park.
No one else calls it.
Looking at a legend in the flesh. Fresh about the kitchen to the check. Blue, king on set. Hold up. Pose. BB's in the chain looking wet. The partner ain't hit the count yet. Same her five, I'm
It's in the back of that notes packet. Is it up there?
Not that.
I've got a new one right there. Yes, it is.
That's like a big deal. That was like a big deal.
I hope you got it.
Yeah.
I have DH. I'm such a young team.
Right, man, stop at the light, man.
Yeah, this is this album that I'm wearing. It's signed on the staff
file. That's
illegal? I think it's
good evening and welcome to the SFA softball field for today's matchup between Lamar University and your SFA Lady Jacks. Fans, Stephen F. Austin University and the SFA Athletic Department would like to remind you that this is a non-smoking facility. We thank you for your cooperation. The Southland Conference and the SFA Athletic Department promote sportsmanlike conduct by student athletes, coaches, and spectators. We request your cooperation by supporting the participants, coaches, and officials in a positive manner. Profanity, racial or sexual comments, or other intimidating actions directed at officials, student athletes, coaches, or team representatives will not be tolerated and are grounds for removal. Before we get started today's game, let's meet the starters. First for Lamar, leading off playing center field, number 8, Alika Tsiasang. Batting second, playing third base, number 2, Nicolette Ramirez. Batting third, playing first base, number 21, Taylor Murphy. At cleanup, playing shortstop, number 3, Hannah Carpenter. Batting fifth, playing second base, number 4, Hannah Kincaid. Batting sixth, playing catcher, number 49, Felicia Hinojosa. Batting seventh, playing designated player, number 20, Victoria Garavey. Batting eighth, playing right field, number 6, Audrey Fleming. And batting ninth, playing left field, number 1, Savannah Mata. And on the mound for the Cardinals is number 25, Shelby Mixon. Lamar is led by head coach Amy Hooks and assisted by Tara McKinney, Robert Armentrout, and Elise LaBouffe. And now, Jack fans, get on your feet and make some noise for your Lady Jack starters. Leading off, playing second base, number 28, Brianna Novigil. Batting second, playing shortstop, number 15, Cameron Middlebrook. Batting third, playing first base, number 12, Shay Govan. Batting cleanup, playing right field, number 2, Gabby Garcia. Batting fifth, playing third base, number 3, Alex Hetzfeld. Batting sixth, playing designated player, number 9, Mackenzie Bennett. Batting seventh, playing left field, number 21, Marissa Arriaga. Batting eighth, playing center field, number 11, Amanda Carden. And batting ninth, playing catcher, number 17, Bailey Richards. On the mound for the Lady Jacks today is number 10, Cassidy Wilbur. SFA is led by head coach Nicole Dixon and assisted by Bryn Baca, Morgan Stearman, and Margarita Corona. Ladies and gentlemen, at this time, please join both teams in honoring America by standing for the playing of our national anthem. Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome here to Lady Jack Park in Nacogdoches as we get ready for this weekend series between the Lamar University Cardinals and your home team, the SFA Lady Jacks. The Lady Jacks coming off a midweek win here. They won that one 2-0. UT Arlington came into Nacogdoches and a game with how many strikeouts from either team. Didn't see a ton of action at the plate. The Lady Jacks able to get two across. Mackenzie Bennett single. Gabby Garcia scoring the second of those two runs. Ran into the UT Arlington shortstop, and the umpire ruled that the shortstop got in her way. Gave the Lady Jacks the second run. As we enter this one, Cassidy Wilbur will start on the mound for the home team. And the Lady Jacks will line up with Bailey Richards at catcher. And Shago Vaughn playing first. Brianna Novigil playing second. And Alex Hedsmith playing third. Cameron Middlebrook rounding out the infield. And then Marissa Arriaga, Amanda Carden, and Gabby Garcia playing in the outfield left to right as Cassidy Wilbur received the first Cardinal batter this afternoon as Aleka Ziasing. First pitch of the game is out of the zone for a ball. Ziasing, a freshman, batting just 187 so far this season, has made 75 plate appearances. Will swing and miss for the first strike of the afternoon. The Cardinals will be fielding a young team this afternoon. Ziasing sends that over the third baseman's head. Hedsmith not able to get up and make the play as the Cardinals with an early base runner here in the top of the first inning with no outs on the board.
Number two, Nicolette Ramirez.
Third baseman Nicolette Ramirez coming to the plate. Ramirez, a sophomore, batting 164 so far this season. The Cardinals coming into this game 2-24. As that one comes in for a first pitch strike. Ramirez, her first time seeing Wilbur, who is pitching an impressive 157 so far this season, has 11 wins and 3 losses to her name and 20 appearances. She's pitched 97 in a third innings. Ramirez fouls that one off and is quickly in an 0-2 count. That one out of the zone for ball one. The count now 2-2 for the sophomore third baseman. As Wilbur's last two pitches are off the plate. That one chopped towards third and gets past the glove of Hedsmith. The Cardinals now with two runners on the base paths and no outs on the board. A team that hasn't hit super well so far in the season, putting pressure on the Lady Jacks early. Go Cards! As Taylor Murphy coming to the plate. Murphy, the junior first baseman, batting 135 so far.
Here we go.
tries to lay down the bunt. Gavon not able to collect. We'll send it over to third. Get the force out at third. Murphy finds her spot at first base.
Number three, Hannah
Carpenter. As Aleka Ziasing. We'll head back to the dugout. Now Hannah Carpenter to the plate. That one finds his own for strike one. Carpenter swings for strike two. As the count now 0-2 for the Cardinal shortstop. That one off the plate for ball one. Wilbur trying to get Carpenter to chase. The 1-2 pitch. Swung on and chopped high as Richards able to find it in the sun for the second out.
Number four, Hannah Pinkade.
The Cardinals still with two on base. Nicolette Ramirez and Taylor Murphy standing on second and first. Will need their teammate Hannah Kincaid to find grass in the outfield if they want to keep this inning alive and get around the base paths to score. That one off the plate for ball one. That one chopped over the press box. The count now 1-1. Kincaid, the sophomore, batting 161 so far. In her 31 plate appearances, has scored 3 runs on 5 hits, 1 double to her name so far. As that one's in the zone for strike two. Wilbur getting instructions for the 1-2 pitch. Ready for the delivery. As that one's fouled off to stay alive here. Cardinal second baseman battling here with the Lady Jack ace. The 1-2 pitch. That one off the plate for ball two. Two's across the board now with 2 balls, 2 strikes, and 2 outs. The Cardinals started the inning with 2 singles. They've not been able to move them around the base path since. As Wilbur will close the door on this inning, the Lady Jacks giving up no runs. The score is 0-0 going into the bottom of the first. We'll be back with your Lady Jack starters here after this.
Fans, just a reminder to return all foul balls to the first base dugout. Thank you.
Get out the way, get out the way, yeah. Get out the way, get the fuck out my way, yeah.
Leading off for your Lady Jacks, number 28, Brianna Novigil.
All right, we are here in the bottom of the first inning as the Lady Jacks come to the plate for the first time this evening, this afternoon rather. They'll see Shelby Mixon on the mound, the senior right-handed pitcher, with an ERA of 11.70. First Lady Jack batter of the afternoon is Brianna Novigil, who has consistently led off for the Lady Jacks this year. The senior second baseman. A big leader on this team for Coach Nicole Dixon. She quickly finds herself in an 0-2 count. Novigil sees the 0-2 pitch. That one off the plate. Second baseman's hitting .354 so far this season. Has 17 runs, 23 hits, 2 doubles, and 1 home run with 13 RBIs in her 65 plate appearances. That one just inside for ball 2. The count now 2 apiece. That one chopped back towards Mixon, who's able to collect and send it over first for the first out.
Heading up next for your Lady Jacks, number 15, Cameron Middlebrook.
Novigil not able to get on the base paths. She'll be followed by Cameron Middlebrook, the shortstop for SFA. The last weekend series we had here in Nacogdoches. This last weekend against the Nicholls State Colonels, and Middlebrook started that weekend off with 2 home runs in the first game of the afternoon. See if she can match that here as she takes the first pitch strike from Mixon. That one off the plate. The count now 1 apiece. Middlebrook hitting .300 so far this season. Has played and started in 17 games. Sends that one sharply down the right field line. That one will land foul. Middlebrook just a little ahead of that pitch. It's the count now 1-2. Middlebrook hits the next pitch she sees and will make her way to first base as Hannah Kincaid not able to collect that one. The Cardinals will be credited with an error there as the Lady Jacks now have a runner on first base with one out here in the bottom of the first. Power bat Shea Govan coming to the plate. Teams learn early to pitch around her as we'll see how the Cardinals attack here. With one out on the board and 2 bases, the umpire calls that 1 a strike. That one off the plate. The count now 1-1 for the Lady Jack slugger. Govan enters the game with a .484 ERA, or average rather. That went inside for ball two. As that one's shot down the third baseline, the Cardinals will just make the play at first as Govan will reach base on a fielder's choice. The Lady Jacks now with two outs on the board.
Lady Jacks, number two, Gabby Garcia.
As Gabby Garcia playing right field today for the Lady Jacks, coming to the plate. Garcia caught in the midweek. As Garcia sends that one towards the Cardinal dugout. Garcia shows bunt early and pulls back and sends that one back to the pitcher as Mixon able to collect. We'll send it over to first base and the inning is over. We'll leave the first with no runs on the board for either team. We will see the bottom half of the Cardinal lineup after this.
Number 49, Alicia Hinojosa.
Welcome back here to the top of the second as we'll see Felicia Hinojosa for the Cardinals catching today. Hinojosa, sophomore, batting 154 so far. Take her first look at Cassie Wilbur. That one just under the zone for ball one. That one chopped towards Govan, who gets the glove up quick, and the out is recorded. Quick reflexes there from the Lady Jack first baseman. Able to get the first out.
Number 20, Victoria Garive.
Designated player this afternoon for the Cardinals is Victoria Garive. She takes ball one. That one off the plate for ball two. Garive, the junior, hitting just 034 so far this season, has made 19 appearances, started 13 of those games. And her 29 plate appearances has zero runs on one hit, that hit being a double. She has two RBIs to her name so far. She's in a 2-1 count here. Needs to find a way on base here if she wants to spark this Lamar offense. That one. Sent towards third, and Headspit's able to collect. The Lady Jacks quickly find two outs here in the top of the second as Audrey Fleming coming to the plate.
Six, Audrey Fleming.
That one finds the zone for strike one. As Fleming batting 111 so far, and her 27 plate appearances has one run on three hits. A home run to her name and three RBIs so far. She takes that one out of the zone for ball one. The count now even for the freshman right fielder. That one finds the zone for strike two. The count now 1-2. Wilbur. Hoping to see the minimum here. Just needs one more strike on Fleming. The 1-2 pitch. Swung on a miss for strike three. Wilbur sees three and sends three back to the dugout. We'll be back with the Lady Jacks at the plate after this.
Hey, yo, street. Country boys is back. It's 6 o'clock. It's time to have a good day.
I got up this morning and I said I'm gonna do something for the United Streets of America. So I got Nappy Roots in here. I got Big Al 360 in here. This is Grand Street certified. And today,
yeah, you're gonna see another street boy playing piano.
Coming up to bat for your Lady Jacks, number three, Alex Hetzpith.
Hetzpith coming to the plate for the Lady Jacks. Her first plate appearance this afternoon. She'll see Shelby Mixon for a second inning. Lady Jack bats were not very productive in the bottom of the first. See if Hetzpith can spark them here. As the first pitch she sees, sends it over to first as Cardinal third baseman Nicolette Ramirez just does a good job of keeping her head out of the way on that one, able to knock it down, not able to collect it. As Hetzpith reaches base with no outs on the board, the Lady Jacks with an early base runner. Mackenzie Bennett follows Hetzpith to the plate. She chops that to third. Ramirez collects and sends it over to second to get Hetzpith out. A little payback for that line drive to her chest earlier. Bennett will reach on a fielder's choice.
Coming up to bat for your Lady Jacks, number 21, Marissa Arriaga.
Left fielder Marissa Arriaga coming to the plate. struggled early this season, and Coach Dixon just sat her down and let her collect her thoughts and take a couple of games off. Has come back into the lineup. Dixon sees her as a senior leader on the team. That one off the plate for ball two. As Arriaga, so far this season, hitting .257. Has 35 plate appearances. Scored 3 runs on 9 hits. 1 double. Has 5 RBIs to her name so far. As that one shot foul towards the Lady Jack dugout. The count now 2-1. Bennett's still on first base. The 2-1 pitch. Missed the zone for ball three. Mixon, got to fight back here. As that one shot back towards her and sent through the middle of the field. Bennett will end up on second base, and the Lady Jacks now with 2 base runners with 1 out on the board. Bennett in scoring position.
Coming up to bat for your Lady Jacks, number 11, Amanda Carden.
Amanda Carden out of the plate. Lady Jacks center fielder. Take her first look at Shelby Mixon. Mixon has pitched 40 innings coming into this game, giving up 86 hits, 59 runs, 52 of those earned. Has walked 14 batters and struck out 16. He had to strike out a Lady Jack early in this one, but has handled the Lady Jack bat so far. As that one's shot towards short. And that one to get through as Bennett's waved home by head coach Dixon. Bennett gets down and does not get to the plate in time as the Lady Jacks have a runner on first and second. Still no score on the board. As Bennett was not able to make it home. The throw made in time. Arriaga now standing on second and Carden on first.
Coming up to bat for your Lady Jacks, number 17, Bailey Richards.
That one in the zone for strike one. Bailey Richards wearing number 17 today, usually wearing number 33. Must have left her jersey on the bus. The catcher for the Lady Jacks finds herself in a 1-1 count here. Richards so far this season hitting .182. Playing in 16 games, starting in 11 of those. In her 33 plate appearances, she scored 3 runs on 6 hits, 2 doubles, and has 5 RBIs to her name. As that one low and out of the zone for ball two. The Lady Jacks have speed on the base paths. They were just thrown out, trying to come home. Richards got to find grass to keep this one alive. as that one just off the plate for ball three. The count now 3-1 for the Lady Jack grad transfer. As that one's into the hands. Umpire calls that one foul. The count now full. 3 balls, 2 strikes, and 2 outs on the board here in the bottom of the second inning. Mixon. Waiting her chance at the payoff pitch. As Richards fouls that one back towards the Lady Jack dugout. Lady Jack catcher doing a good job of staying alive in this at bat. Fouling off pitches on the edge. Making sure she doesn't take an easy strike. The 3-2 pitch. That one swung and hit foul again. As we have a good battle here between Richards and Mixon. Mixon's given up 3 hits so far this inning. None coming across the plate. I'd like to get out of this one here. As that one's chopped down the first baseline, and that one will be fair, coming off the first baseman's glove. The Lady Jacks will send 2 home as the ball is still in the corner. Richards will go all the way to third as she stays on the base. And the Lady Jacks put 2 on the board with 2 outs. Grad transfer. Bailey Richards doing her job. Chops that one just down the first baseline. And the Lady Jacks with a 2-0 lead here early in this one.
Running up next for your Lady Jacks, number 28, Rihanna Novigil.
We head back to the top of the lineup card for the Lady Jacks as Brianna Novigil coming to the plate. As Novigil takes first pitch she sees, strike. Lady Jacks with a run on third base as Bailey Richards made it all the way around the bags. On her triple and her last at bat, Novigil with an opportunity to extend the Lady Jacks lead if she can find this, get this one out of the infield. The count now 0-2 quickly to Novigil. The Lady Jacks second baseman grounded out to Mixon in her first at bat. Like to see this one get past the dirt as that one's off the plate for ball one. Mixon, ready for the 1-2 delivery. That one off the plate again. The count now 2-2. 2 balls, 2 strikes, and 2 outs on the board. As Richards waits her chance to come home. Novigil just got to find grass. That one in the hands. The count now full for the senior second baseman. The Lady Jacks already put 2 on the board this inning. Would like to add another as a 3-2 pitch. So that was off the bat for ball four, and the Lady Jacks now with 2 on base here in the bottom of the second. As Cameron Middlebrook coming to the plate next for the home team.
Coming up to bat for your Lady Jacks, number 15, Cameron Middlebrook.
Middlebrook reached on an error her last time at the plate. Cardinal head coach coming out to the pitching circle. Talk to her senior pitcher. Just walking her through the situation. Two runners on the base paths, one at third, one at first. Have a 300 hitter at the plate with a monster hitter behind her in Shea Govan. The Cardinals going to want to get this out and not give Govan an opportunity to bring multiple runs across the plate. As Hooks heads back to the dugout. That one finds the zone for strike one. Makes it in a big spot here. As that one's fouled off by Middlebrook. The count now 0-2. Mixon done a good job of working ahead of this batter. Middlebrook awaits the 0-2 pitch. As that one's in the dirt, and Arriaga going to come home. Rather, Bailey Richards came home. Richards hitting that triple earlier, comes around to score. The Lady Jacks now extend their lead. 3-0 here in the bottom of the second. As Novigil will make her way to second. The count 1-2 for the Lady Jacks shortstop. As that one's fouled off. That one off the plate. Two balls, two strikes, and two outs now for Cameron Middlebrook. Middlebrook reached on an error her last at bat and then was thrown out at second in a fielder's choice as that one will hit Middlebrook, and the Lady Jacks now with a runner on first and second with two outs on the board here. Mixon just can't get the final out.
Number 12, Shea Govan.
As Shea Govan comes to the plate. Hit into a fielder's choice, her first at bat. Has an opportunity to bring two around here if she can get a hold of this one. Mixon not going to want to pitch to her here. With the base open and Gabby Garcia up next. It's a tough decision to make here. As that one misses the plate for ball one. Govan's hitting an impressive 484 so far, but Garcia following her is keeping the bats hot at 373. Coach Dixon earlier this week talking about how impressed she's been with Gabby Garcia, who follows Govan in the lineup almost every game and has done a good job of keeping that bat hot and getting a hit after Govan has walked or finds her way on base. The count now 1-1 for the sophomore first baseman. That one low and out of the zone for ball two.
Yeah.
The 2-1 pitch. Swung on and chopped. Foul down the third baseline. As that one just misses the bag. Third baseman Nicolette Ramirez got down in the dirt to make the play. That one bouncing just foul. Govan sends that one well into left field. That one will head over the fence for a three-run home run. The Lady Jacks extend their lead to six here in the bottom of the second as Govan hits her seventh home run of the year. That one left on a platter for the Lady Jack first baseman, and that was a no-doubter from the second it hit the bat. The Lady Jacks put up six here in the bottom of the second with more to come as Gabby Garcia now comes to the plate.
Coming up to bat for your Lady Jacks, number two, Gabby Garcia.
Garcia takes the first pitch she sees as a strike. Garcia, the last batter to the plate for the Lady Jacks this inning. As that one chopped back to the mound and sent over to first. The Lady Jacks put up six here in the bottom of the second. As the Cardinals still without a run, we will be back with more Lady Jack softball after this. We're about ready for the start of the third inning here. The Lady Jacks put up six in the bottom of the second, if you've just joined us. As Savannah Mata coming to the plate. The last Cardinal yet to see Lady Jack ace, Cassidy Wilbur. That one off the plate for ball one. Mata, the left fielder, got to watch a Shea Govan home run go over her head in the last half inning. As the Lady Jack bats got hot with two outs on the board. You count now 1-1. That one out of the zone for ball two. Mod hitting 206 so far this season with 34 plate appearances, has scored once on seven hits, two doubles. No RBIs to her name so far. As that one's into the hands, we'll take ball three. The 3, 1 pitch from Wilbur. That one in the zone. The count now full. The 3-2 pitch finds the zone for strike three, and that's Wilbur's third strikeout of the afternoon so far. As we head back to the top of the Cardinals lineup card, we'll see Aleka Siasang. As that one finds his own for strike one. Siasang started to move on that one, trying to lay down a slap. As that one misses the zone for ball one. As that one's fouled back towards the press box, finding the net. Cardinals have a lot of work to do here to make up for those 6 Lady Jack runs. They have lots of time to do it, as we're just in the third inning. As that one sent towards third, and Hedspeth able to collect that one and record the first out.
Number 2, Nicolette Ramirez.
Hedspeth and Govan playing up on that one. Made Hedspeth make the play quicker than she would have if she was back at the base. As Nicolette Ramirez now to the bag. Takes that one. In at the knees for ball one. Ramirez singled her last at bat. 1 of 2 Cardinals to get a hit on Cassie Wilbur so far. As that one's fouled over the Lady Jack locker room. No runners on the base paths and 2 outs on the board. The Cardinals are going to need to get to work here in the top of the third to try to erase some of those runs the Lady Jacks put up in the bottom of the second. As that one's high and out of the zone for ball two. Ramirez can start the action here. She can find herself on base. The Lady Jacks doing all their damage with 2 outs on the board. So certainly don't cart the Cardinals out of this inning. As that one just misses the zone for ball three. You can feel everyone in the grandstands waiting for a call there. And you can feel everyone on the field also waiting for that call. As the count now 3-1 for the Cardinal third baseman. That one out of the zone for ball four, as the Cardinals have a 2-out base runner on first.
Number 21, Taylor Murphy.
The first batter of the afternoon, the Wilbur's walked. Wilbur walking just 34 batters rather so far this season. Ramirez being the 35th in her 97 innings of work. She's also struck out 132. Had a couple so far for this game, as Murphy takes a half swing at that one. Take the first strike of the at-bat. Murphy reached on a fielder's choice the last time she was at the plate. As that one's fouled back for strike one. Strike two, rather.
Right here.
Wilbur wants to see the signs again from catcher Bailey Richards. As that one sent over to first. Novigil not on the bag to make the tag. Murphy, showing bunt early, will pull back. Swing and hit that one high towards short center field. Second baseman, Brianna Novigil, goes back to make the play, and the Lady Jacks get out of the inning, giving up no runs. They will take a 6-0 lead into the bottom of the third. We'll be back with more Lady Jack softball after this.
Coming up to bat for your Lady Jacks, number 3, Alex Hipsmith.
Leading off this inning is the same Lady Jack to lead off the last inning. Alex Hedspeth to the plate. Singled in her last at bat. Hedspeth was thrown out in a fielder's choice. It was the first of 9 Lady Jacks to come to the plate in the bottom of the second. The Lady Jacks putting up 6 runs. As Mixon out for another inning of work. Missed the zone for ball 1. That one misses the zone again. Hedspeth, you had to see one come across the plate as she is in a 3-0 count. That one finds zone for strike 1. Hedspeth and started taking a half step to first base, thinking that one had missed the zone. As that one out of the zone for ball 4. Hedspeth will find herself on first base for the second time in as many innings.
Coming up to
as Mackenzie Bennett now to the plate. Hit into the fielder's choice in the bottom of the second. It's all Hedspeth get out at first. Bennett, the designated player for the Lady Jacks. Hitting 303 so far this season. Take a big swing in the first pitch she sees, and Hedspeth will steal second base. Lady Jack third baseman beats the throw.
Coming up to bat for your Lady
the 1 pitch.
Off the plate.
As Mixon. Trying to have a quicker inning than the last one. As Bennett takes a big swing at that one. Fouled off for strike two. The way to Jacks with a runner in scoring position and no outs on the board. Edsmith's one of the more athletic players on this Lady Jack team. If Bennett can find grass in the outfield, she has a chance to come all the way home. As Mixon will look for a new ball from the home plate umpire. The 1-2 pitch swung on and chopped foul down the third baseline. That one towards Bennett's head coach, Nicole Dixon. Dixon in her fifth season at SFA. Her eighth total season of coaching. Has a 117-92 record here in purple and white. Spent her playing days at Eastern New Mexico. As that one fouled off again down the third base line. Made a couple stops in the junior college rank as a coach, amassing an impressive 137-43 record in her three seasons at multiple universities. Coach Jason is joined by assistant coach Brim Baca, who played at Lamar University. As Bennett sends that one down the first baseline this time, and it will land foul. Brim Baca and Morgan Spearman, the two assistant coaches on this staff. Spearman playing at Angelo State. And Lady Jack legend Margarita Corona, now the GA for the Lady Jacks this season. As that one's in the dirt, and Hedsmith will take third base without a throw. The count now 2-2 for the Lady Jack designated player. She sends that one towards short. And the Cardinals not able to collect. That'll bring home another Lady Jack run. Score now 7-0. And Bennett with an RBI single.
Coming up to bat for your Lady Jacks, number 21, Marissa Arriaga.
The Cardinals now coming to the center circle to talk with their pitcher. Pinch runner now on first base for the Lady Jacks. Looks like it's number 18, Lexi Benson. Benson started in the midweek for the Lady Jacks. Coming in to maybe flash her speed for Bennett. Lady Jack still with no outs on the board. And Marissa Arriaga to the plate, who singled and came around in her last at bat. As that one's off the plate for ball one. There's an arm warming up for the Cardinals out on the left field bullpen as Arriaga shows bunt in that one. landing foul. Ariaga and a 1-2 count here. She sends that one foul over the Cardinal dugout. The count now 2-2. No outs on the board. There is a brisk breeze coming in from right center field towards home plate. Feels like a typical spring day here in Nacogdoches. 81 degrees. You can feel all 81 of them with the heat as Ariaga sends that out to left. That one collected by the Cardinals as they record the first out here of the third inning.
Coming up to bat for your Lady Jacks, number 11,
Amanda Carden, out of the plate.
I know you didn't get your hand down so you can just sit down and just sit.
Hey, we should have a good shot tonight. Let's go, baby. It's your birthday. No, it's not. Bring it down, man. Bring it
down. Here we go. Here we go. Here we go. Carden taking the first pitch he sees as a strike. The Lady Jacks center fielder singled her last at bat, came around to score as part of a six-run inning for the Lady Jacks. We've added one here. That one. Misses the plate for ball one. Nick's unable to find the zone again for the second ball of the at-bat. The count now 2-1. As that one. That is a zone for a third straight pitch as Amanda Carden waiting to see one come across the plate. Yeah, she swings and sits, hits that one well towards center field. The Cardinals able to get back and make the play. Yeah, as pinch runner Lexi Benson will head back to first. Lady Jacks now with two outs on the board. And Bailey Richards coming to the plate.
Coming up to bat for your Lady Jacks, number 17, Bailey Richards.
Bailey Richards tripled her last at bat, bringing around two for her first two RBIs of the afternoon. She later came around and scored as she scored on a passed ball. As that one in the zone for a strike. Richards quickly in an 0-2 count. The grad student out of Des Moines, Iowa, has actually played her whole career here at SFA, starting in the community college ranks. And spoke and said she was a grad transfer earlier as she chops that down the third baseline. That one stays foul for another chance at the plate. Mix in with the 0-2 delivery. That one off the plate for first ball of the at bat. Bennett chops that back, and a no man's land will beat the throw as Benson will slide it into third base, safe. The Lady Jacks now have a runner in scoring position at third with Brianna Novigil coming to the plate.
Coming up to bat for your Lady Jacks, number 28, Brianna Novigil.
Novigil walked in her last at bat. Came around to score as part of the Che Govan three-run RBI, three-run home run. Novigil also grounded out to the pitcher in her first plate appearance as she takes strike one. The Lady Jack second baseman's been to the plate three times and we're in the bottom of the third as Mixon just not able to close out these innings. The Lady Jack scored all six with two outs on the board last time. As that one's off the plate for ball one. Novigil came into the game hitting over 350. As that one misses again. The count now 2-1. That one misses for ball three. Novigil chops that one just foul down the first baseline. As that one found the corner, could have been dangerous. Similar hit from Bailey Richards in the second inning. Brought around two and got her to third base. Novigil has speed. If that one gets caught in the corner, could have been very dangerous for the Cardinals here in the third inning. As that one's fouled off, and that one will end the inning as the Lady Jacks bring one around on the Mackenzie Bennett RBI single. We'll be back with more Lady Jack softball after this.
Yeah. I've been blind for a while now. I just got the key that let me in. No ID. Doors opening up for me and now I see. I've been blind for a while now. I've been blind for a while now. I've been blind. Hey! Next thing you next to who's made of us, man, and we're catching kill.
see the way it charts. I wonder if he ever gonna stop. And he charged out of 50 for the verse. Now, fade away, never ever drop. They noticed it in the first time. Wonder if he ever gonna pop. Go!
I just got the key, they let me in. No ID. Doors opening up for me, and now I see. I've been blind for a while now.
Let's go!
I just got the key, they let me in. No ID. Doors opening up for me, and now I see. I've been blind for a while now. I've been blind for a while now.
I've been quarantined, living with my kids. I've been trying to see how to catch up.
We are back here with the fourth inning of action in Nacogdoches. The Lady Jacks enter this inning with a 7-0 lead as the shortstop Hannah Carpenter coming to the plate for the Cardinals. She'll get her second look at Cassidy Wilbur, who's had a lengthy break. Since the first pitch she sees towards second, Cameron Middlebrook able to collect that one off the bounce and make the play over at first. As Hannah Kincaid will now come to the plate.
Number four, Hannah Kincaid.
Cardinals second baseman. Struck out her first at bat. We'll see if she can change the fortunes here for the Cardinals in this first game of this weekend series. As that one misses the zone for ball one. She sends that one high and towards third dugout as it'll land safely on top of the Cardinals dugout. Headsmith was chasing that one. Would have been in position if it had landed in the field of play. That one off the plate for ball two. Kincaid entering the game with a 161. Batting average. Look to be a little more effective here at the plate. She tries to keep the Cardinals' hopes alive. There's still time in this game to come back. As Wilbur readjusting her circle, kicking some dirt around. She finds herself in the hole 3-1. The Cardinals sophomore takes strike two. She thought that one had missed the zone and was on her way to first base. She'll step back into the box for a full count from Cassidy Wilbur. The 3-2 pitch. Chopped back towards the netting. Kincaid now fighting to stay alive in this one. The 3-2 pitch off the plate for ball four as Kincaid will make her way to first. The Cardinals now with a one out base runner. As Wilbur just walked her second batter of the afternoon. We'll see Felicia Hinojosa, the catcher, grounded out to first, rather lined out to first in her first at bat. Hit that one hard towards Shago Vaughn, who was able to get the glove up in time and make the play. That one finds his own for strike one. as that one's hit well into right center field. As Lady Jacks let that one fall, and Garcia able to get over to second in time to get the lead runner, Hannah Kincaid, out. Who had held up between first and second in case she needed to head back to first.
Number 20, Victoria Garvey.
Two outs on the board now is Victoria Garive coming to the plate. Garive takes the ball on the first pitch she sees. She swings underneath that one for strike one. That one sent to second as Middlebrook able to collect and will send it over to first. Get the third out of the inning. The Lady Jacks don't allow the Cardinals to bring any across the plate as the score is 7-0 going into the bottom of the fourth inning. We'll be back with more Lady Jacks softball after this.
For your Lady Jacks, number 15, Cameron Middlebrook.
Middlebrook coming to the plate now for the Lady Jacks here in the bottom of the fourth inning. Middlebrook has reached on air and hit by a pitch in her first two plate appearances. Came around to score in the second, as part of the Shea Govan home run, as she takes first pitch strike. As that one chopped down the third baseline and foul. Count now quickly 0-2 for the Lady Jack shortstop. As that one fell back into the grandstands. As the count now still 0-2 as Mixon's still on the mound for the Cardinals. Thank you. Middlebrook sends that one high and towards the shortstop as Lady Jacks.
Coming up to bat for your lady.
We'll see their first out of the inning.
Shea Govan
to the plate. Hit a three-run home run over the left field wall her last time at the plate. Can't imagine we're going to see too many pitches towards her. She chops the first pitch she sees down the third baseline, and that one will roll foul. The 0-1 pitch swung on and hit back towards the Cardinal dugout again. Two quick fouls for the Lady Jack slugger. The Lady Jacks have scored in their last two innings at the plate. See if they can keep the run parade going as that one's off the plate for ball one. Govan showing bunt early. He'll likely pull it back and take a full swing if anything comes near the plate. That one low and out of the zone for ball two. The count now 2-2 for the Lady Jack sophomore. Mixon doing a better job against the Lady Jack batters so far this inning. Got to find a way to get Shea Govan out as that one's low and out of the zone for ball three. She's gotten Govan to foul off too. Got to find a way to get one past her. Last time she floated one across the plate for Govan, who got all of it. As that one missed the zone for ball four as the Lady Jacks now with a one-out base runner. And Gabby Garcia coming to the plate.
Number two, Gabby Garcia.
Garcia hasn't had a productive day at the plate so far. Hitting well into the 300s, though. Doing a good job protecting Shea Govan, who gets a lot of walks from a lot of teams. Takes her first strike of the at-bat. Garcia shows bunt early, will pull back. And that one off the plate for ball one. As Garcia chops that to third. And that one to get past the second baseman as Govan will head to third. She's waved home by Morgan Spearman, who's now at the third base bag. Garcia finds herself at third base as the Lady Jacks extend their lead to 8-0 here in the bottom of the fourth inning.
Coming up to bat for your Lady Jacks, number three, Alex
Hedspeth to the plate. Singled and walked her last two plate appearances. Stole two bases the last time she was on the base paths. Give me a that one. Sent high into foul territory as that one will land just over the grandstands. The count now 0-2 for the Lady Jack third baseman. That one chopped up the line for a single as Headsmith will get one out RBI. Lady Jacks continue a good performance at the plate as the score now 9-0 here. And Gabby Garcia coming around to score.
Coming up to bat for your Lady Jacks, number 18, Lexi Benson.
Lexi Benson is officially coming in the game as a batter for the designated player, Mackenzie Bennett. Takes the first pitch she sees of the afternoon as a strike. As that one's out of the zone for ball one. Benson sends that one just foul down the first baseline. The count now 1-2 for the new Lady Jack batter. The Lady Jacks have Headsmith on first. Had two stolen bases her last time on the base paths. She's not really made an attempt to run as she goes now. That one will hit her as she reaches second safely. That pitch was in the dirt for ball two. Mix in. Ready for the 2-2 delivery. Finds the zone for strike three as Lexi Benson will head back to the dugout.
Coming up to bat for your Lady Jacks, number 21.
Lady Jacks now with two outs on the board. Hasn't stopped the Lady Jacks before as they scored all six of theirs in the second with two outs. As Mr. Arriaga comes to the plate. Has singled and flown out in her first two plate appearances. As that one misses the zone for ball one. Arriaga sends that one into short left field as Headsmith will make her way to third. Arriaga on at first for a two-out single.
Coming up to bat for your Lady Jacks, number 23, Alex DeBose.
Another substitution for the Lady Jacks. Number 23, Alex DeBose, coming to the plate for Amanda Carden. Bose takes a strike in the first pitch she sees. Lady Jacks with a runner on first and third with two outs on the board. as Arriaga will take off towards second. And that'll bring Headsmith home. The Lady Jacks make it 10 here in the fourth inning. Arriaga doing a good job of forcing the throw from the catcher. Felicia Hinojosa, the sophomore. We should have held on to that with the Lady Jack at third, but tries to get the Lady Jack out at second. And that brings one home. With two outs on the board, doesn't make too much of a difference if Arriaga takes second there, as you're worried about the out at the plate. Count now 1-2. As that one's chopped high, and the Cardinals make a diving play for the third out. The Lady Jacks bring three more around as the score is now 10-0 here heading into the top of the fifth. We'll be back with more Lady Jack softball after this.
Number 30, Reagan Moss.
Audrey Fleming coming to the plate for the Cardinals. We'll see a new Lady Jack pitcher as Reagan Mock comes to the center circle.
Number 6, Audrey Fleming.
That one out of the zone for ball one. Mock not able to find the zone in her first two pitches. As she finds the first strike out of her, first strike rather, of her day. The 2-1 pitch out of the zone for ball three. Mock making her ninth appearance so far. Has a 1-2 record as that one's chopped foul down the third baseline. The count now full for the Cardinal right fielder. Mock enters the game with a 4.91 ERA. has walked six batters and struck out six. There's a chance to do some damage here in a 3-2 count. As that one just off the plate for ball four. And the Cardinals now with a leadoff base runner. The Cardinals will make a move for a pinch hitter. Number 27, Kaylee Ancelot coming into the game.
Number 27, Kaylee Ancelot. Go, Kaylee.
As Mock misses the zone for ball one. The 1-0 pitch finds the zone for strike one. The count now 1-1. The Cardinals do have a base runner on first. As they look to find some sort of offense here late in this one. As that one finds the top of the zone for a strike two. Mock doing a good job of getting ahead of this one. As Ancelot now finds himself in a 1-2 count. Mock with 1-2 delivery. Swung on and hit just foul of the base peg at third base. Ancelot will come back to the batter's box. That one high and out of the zone for ball one. Ball two, rather. Richard's doing a good job of getting up and getting that one. If that one had gotten overhead, the runner at first would have at least gotten to second. Mock. Going to work back now. The 2-2 pitch. Swung on and chopped towards second as Middlebrook able to corral it and tries to flip it over to Novigil, who's just not able to bring it in. Novigil was already thinking about the double play. And the Cardinals now with a runner on first and second with no outs on the board. Really good effort by Middlebrook to get there and get a glove to the ball.
Number eight, I like this
as
thing.
Infield coming in to talk to. Their pitcher let her know that that one's not on her. They let that one get past her as Aleka Sising now coming to the bag. The Cardinals did bring in a pinch runner. Might be number seven, Reagan Jones. Maybe number five, Brooke Smith. It's hard to tell the numbers on the back of their jerseys. Sia Singh will take strike one. The count now 0-2. Mock trying to court her first out. That one off the plate. that one. High and out of the zone for ball two. The count now two apiece. Mark the freshman out of Robinson, Texas. Gets a swing and a miss for the first strikeout of the afternoon for the Lady Jack freshman. We'll now see Nicolette Ramirez.
Number two, Nicolette Ramirez.
Two runners still on the base paths for the Cardinals. One at first, one at second. As Ramirez gets her first luck at Mock. We'll take a first pitch swing for strike one. Ramirez. Close time to step out. That's that one. Just misses the zone for ball one. That one. High at the shoulder of Ramirez. Able to get out of the way and takes ball two. That one in the dirt. Richards will send it over to third as Hedsmith not able to collect, and Middlebrook will try to make the play at home as Richards gets the out at home. Coach Hooks is going to come out and see your player who's
cannot be in the base path.
We will take a break here as home plate umpire has a conversation and the Cardinal gets up. Back here and the Cardinals have one more out on the board as away fans not happy with the call and home plate umpire gonna have some words for Hooks.
What took so long to figure that out, Blue?
Hooks still fighting for a team and may have a point there as Baylor Richards applies the tag and now two outs on the board. Nicolette Ramirez still at the plate for Cardinals.
blow to her next time.
Number
20. So that one's fouled off. The count now full. Counting now 3-2. Freshman pitcher for the Lady Jacks has an opportunity to get out of this one. As that one's shot towards third, don't get past the glove of Govan. The Cardinals will bring one around. Score now 10-1 here in the fifth inning.
Number 10, Haley Friedenberg.
As the Cardinals now making a substitution at the plate. Taylor Murphy will make way for number 10, Haley Friedenberg. The home plate umpire thought that he was going to get an earful from Coach Hooks, who just came to tell him who the player that was substituted was, as Mock finds first pitch strike. That one high and out of the zone for ball one. Count now one apiece here for the new Cardinal batter, who will chop that one foul towards the backstop. Count now 1-2. Two outs on the board with a controversial play earlier. That one out of the zone. Richards does a good job of getting behind it for the second ball of the at-bat. That one. Chop bag towards Mock is able to collect and sends it over to Govan for the third out of the inning. The Cardinals grab one back as the score is 10-1 going into the bottom of the fifth. We'll be back with more Lady Jack softball after this. Well, it appears the game is actually over here in Nacogdoches as the first of the doubleheader has a final of 10-1. We'll be back with more Lady Jack softball after we take a little break.
Final score for today's game, SFA 10.